Welcome to Real Chemistry. Today we're going to be talking about Hess's law, and we're going to be doing some practice problems. Now, these problems use some rules that I've written down here to go from reference reactions, where we know their enthalpies, that's what's listed up top, to a target reaction, where we don't know the enthalpy. And the whole goal of these problems is to figure out that enthalpy for that target reaction. And I'll show you how we'll do that. Now, if you haven't yet watched my video, Introduction to Hess's Law, go ahead and check that out first. We go through each one of these rules one by one, and it'll give you a much better understanding of what these rules do. All right, so our goal then is gonna be to use these rules to take our reference reactions and build up our target reaction. So let's talk about how we're gonna do that. Well, we are gonna look carefully at our reference reactions, and we're gonna make sure that the numbers in our reference reactions, when we add them together for each of the reactants and products, are gonna match what's in our target reaction. We're also gonna wanna check and make sure that our reactants and our products are on the correct side in our reference reactions, so that when we add them up, they'll get our target reaction. Now this may sound a little confusing to you, and this is one of those things in chemistry that just takes a few times practicing it to get the hang of it. So what we're gonna do, first off, is make sure that anything we see in our target reaction are on the correct side in our reference reactions. So let me show you what I mean there. I have iron down here. It's a reactant. So I'm gonna look up in my reference reactions and see where iron is. It's right here. And notice it's on the reactant side, just like it is in my target reaction. That means it's on the correct side. Chlorine, it's on the reactant side of my target reaction, and it's on the reactant side in my reference reactions. That's good. What this means is I don't need to flip those reactions. If I looked and I had reactants in my target reaction that were products in those top reactions, the reference reactions, then I could flip them. And I could flip them using rule one, that flips the enthalpy sign. So what we're really checking for here is, do I need to flip my reference reactions? Okay, last thing we're gonna check for is my product on the right side? Well, here I have iron 3 chloride, and it's a product. And if I look above, reference reaction 2 has iron 3 chloride as a product. So my products are on the correct side, my reactants are on the correct side, so I don't need to flip any of my reactions. So that's the first thing you wanna check. You wanna check, do I need to flip my reactions? The second thing you wanna check is, are the numbers of my reactants and products correct? So here you'll notice I have 2 irons. Up top in my reference reaction, I only have 1. So right now, I don't have the correct number of irons. How can I get the correct number of irons? Well, that's where rule 2 comes through. Rule 2 says multiply a reaction by X, and you can figure out what that enthalpy will be by multiplying it by X also. So this is a good hint right off the bat that I need to multiply reaction 1 by 2, and that's going to give me my 2 irons that I need. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to take this whole reaction 1, and I'm going to multiply it by 2. And then I'll figure out what the new enthalpy for that is, and all I have to do there is multiply this enthalpy by 2. So when I write down this new reaction, I get my 2 irons, which is good, because that's what I want. And the reason I get that is I multiply this 2 by that 1, and that gives me 2. Now I get out chlorines, and I had 1 chlorine in the first reference reaction. When I multiply that by 2, I get out 2 chlorines. And those guys are gonna go to the product, which is iron 2 chloride, this guy, and now there's 2 of them. Okay, so that's reference reaction 1 multiplied by 2. What's the enthalpy for that guy? Well, the enthalpy for that guy is just 2 times negative 340. Remember that the enthalpy change for our first reference reaction was negative 340. And now if I just multiply that by 2, I get the new enthalpy of reaction. And when I multiply that by 2, I get negative 680 kilojoules. Okay, so now the number of irons I have matches. Let's look at the other numbers in my target reaction and see if they match. Chlorine, you'll notice, I have 3 there, and I don't have 3 in either of my reference reactions. Now, I've multiplied reference reaction 1 by 2, and that gives me 2 chlorines right here, as you can see. So I'm close to getting the right number of chlorines, but I need more. And where I can get them is for my second reaction, where I have half a chlorine. If I take my 2 chlorines that I already have and add a half, that doesn't quite get me 3. So that's a good hint that I'm gonna need to multiply reaction 2 by 2. just like I did with the first one. Another reason you can see that is when I go to my product and my target reaction, I notice that I want 2 of iron, 3 chloride. And in my reference reaction 2, I only have 1 iron, 3 chloride. So how am I going to get 2 of those? I'm going to multiply that whole thing by 2. So this is going to look very similar to what I just did. I'm going to multiply this whole thing by 2, and that means I'll need to multiply the enthalpy by 2. And so when I do that, I'm going to get 2 FeCl2 solid, because I had 1 and then I multiplied that by 2, plus 1 chlorine. I get 1 chlorine because I multiplied that half up here by 2. So that 2 times 1 half gives me 1. And that's going to go then to 2 iron 3 chlorides. Okay, what's the delta H of reaction there? The delta H of reaction is just 2 times what I started with. And I started with a negative 58. And since I multiplied the whole reaction by 2, I can just multiply the negative 58 by 2. And when I do that, that's going to give me negative 116 kilojoules. So, now, I have the correct numbers of reactants and products. And they're on the correct sides. The last thing I'm going to do, and this is almost always the last step for Hess's Law problems, is I'm going to add those reactions together. So, what does that look like? Well, I'm going to draw a line here to show that the stuff I draw below it has been added. And what we're going to do is we're just going to bring down all my reactants and all my products. You'll see here that I have iron solid, so we're going to bring that down. 2Fe solid. The next thing you'll notice is that I have 2 chlorines here and 1 chlorine there. So that's going to give me a total of 3 chlorines. Now, when I add reactions together, if one of them gives me a product that matches a reactant in the other one, then they can cancel out. So the top one gives me 2 iron chlorides. The bottom one takes those iron chlorides away. So that means we can just forget about these. If you want, you can write them down on the reactant side and the product side and then realize you can cancel them. But right here, since we see them on opposite sides of the arrow, we can get rid of them. They're the same thing. The top reaction's making them, the bottom reaction's taking them away. All right, and then the very last thing, which I haven't taken care of, is this 2 iron 3 chloride. So that's gonna give me 2 FeCl3. Now, first thing to notice, that matches my target reaction. I have exactly the same thing there as I did in my target reaction, and that's because I matched the numbers of each reactant and product, and I made sure they were on the right side. And since we've added those reactions together, now we follow rule 3, which says when you add the reactions, add the delta H's. So all I'm going to do to get the final answer for my problem is add these two guys together. And when I take minus 680 and I add minus 116, I get minus 796 kilojoules. So Hess's law allowed us to calculate the enthalpy that our target reaction has by using our reference reactions. Like I said, this is one of those things in chemistry that until you practice it a few times, it feels a little sketchy. So try it out yourself. In fact, a good opportunity is right now. This is another practice problem we're gonna do. Go ahead and pause the video, give that problem a try. It's okay if you mess up. The first time you try these, you usually do mess up. And then we'll go through how to do it correctly. So once again, we're gonna start by seeing if our reactants and our products are on the correct side. You'll notice that our very first reactant in our target reaction is carbon. And you'll notice that in reaction 1, carbon's on the left side. It's a reactant also. So that's good. They're on the correct side. Similarly, oxygen is on the correct side in both reference reactions. It's a reactant there. Now, we want to get out 2 carbon monoxide. And the only place we see carbon monoxide is right here. And what that means is it's on the reactant side. That's the wrong side. So we're gonna have to flip reaction 2 if we ever wanna get carbon monoxide to be on the product side. So we're gonna flip this guy. All right, so let's erase all of that. And we're just gonna flip this reaction and I'm gonna rewrite it on the bottom. So we're gonna flip reaction 2. And what that looks like is we put our products over here, 2 CO2 gas, and that splits apart into oxygen gas plus two carbon monoxide gas. And the enthalpy of that reaction just flips sign. So we had up here negative 566, but since we flipped the reaction, our enthalpy for this reaction will just change signs. So it used to be negative 566, and now it's positive 566. Okay, so we flipped that reaction, and now our carbon monoxide's on the correct side. Now what we want to do is start thinking about the numbers of reactants and products that we have. Here we see that we want to have two solid carbons in our reactants. And up in reference reaction one, we only have one carbon. So that's a good hint that we're going to have to multiply this by two. So that's also going to give us the correct number of oxygens, and I'll show you how that's true in a second. So we have to multiply that by two. So that's going to give us two carbon solid, and that's going to give us two oxygens on the reactant side. And that's going to go to two carbon dioxides. Okay, now how do we figure out the enthalpy of that reaction? Well, since we multiplied reference reaction one by two, all we have to do is multiply this guy by two. And so we're going to multiply 394 by two, and that's going to give us 788. So that's going to give us negative 788. All right, so we multiplied this enthalpy of reaction by two, and that gave us negative 78 kilojoules. Now, the last step we're going to do is we're going to add these reactions together. When we do that, we have a couple things to notice. One is on both sides of the arrow, as a reactant in the top one and as a product in the bottom one, we have two carbon dioxides. So those cancel out. Another thing to notice is that we have oxygen as a product here and oxygen as a reactant there, but they're not in equal numbers. So the top one makes an oxygen. The bottom one takes up two of those oxygens. So the whole oxygens don't cancel out, just the two. What that means is basically you subtracted those numbers. So I give you one oxygen and I take two oxygens away. So on the whole, I'm taking one oxygen away. So we keep one oxygen on the reactant side. And now we're going to add these reactions up, and we'll see that our reactants are two carbon solids plus now just one oxygen. So that's a little tricky. But because we made one oxygen and we took two away, that means we are left with one oxygen on the reactant side. Perhaps another way to see that is we have one oxygen on the product side, but two oxygens on the reactant side. And that means that we can just subtract those two numbers, two minus one, gives us our one oxygen. All right, and then on the product side, we're gonna get out two carbon monoxides. So we've taken into account this carbon solid, we get it down bottom. We've taken into account this oxygen, we get it down there in the reactants, and we've taken into account our two carbon monoxides. Notice now that our reaction we just built matches the reference or the target reaction exactly. Two carbon solid plus one oxygen goes to two carbon monoxides. And now we're in a position to calculate the enthalpy of reaction. So all we have to do is add together the enthalpies for these two reactions above. So it says add reactions, add the enthalpies. So all we have to do is 566 kilojoules minus 788 kilojoules. And when we do that, what we're gonna get out is minus 222 kilojoules. So that's our final answer. The enthalpy for our target reaction is minus 222 kilojoules. So this is gonna take a little bit of practice to get a handle of. So go ahead and do some more practice problems. Go through, watch this video again if you need to. And once you try it a few times, you'll start to get the hang of it, and you'll see that these problems aren't so bad once you get that practice in. Thanks for watching Real Chemistry. If you have any further questions, please ask them below. You can also subscribe to receive updates about future chemistry videos.